Hello friends, my name is Chinmay Deshpande and today we are going to see C programming explanation of Runge Kutta method for solution of ODE, that is ordinary differential equation. First of all, we will understand what is ODE. Ordinary differential equations are of great importance in engineering field. Most of the physical laws are formulated with the help of differential equation. Around 80% of engineering applications are governed by differential equations. So numerical methods provide some techniques to solve those equations. What do you mean by ordinary differential equation? When a differential equation contains all the derivatives with respect to a single variable, then it is called as an ordinary differential equation. For example, alpha d square y upon dx square plus b dy by dx plus cy equal to 0 is the example of ordinary differential equation. The above equation contains derivatives with respect to x only, hence it is called as an ordinary differential equation. Now let us understand what is a practical example of ODE. According to the Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, the induced voltage in a coil is given by the equation V equal to N d phi upon dt, where V is the induced voltage in volts, N is the number of turns in the coil, and d phi by dt is the rate of change of flux phi with respect to the time t. So this particular equation is also an example of ordinary differential equation. In most of the engineering applications, when represented mathematically, they results into a differential equation. The analytical solution to all differential equations is not possible, and that's why numerical methods are used for solving these equations. Numerical methods provides an easier and approximate solution for a differential equation. Fourth order RK method. To solve dy by dx equal to f of xy, that is function in terms of x and y, with initial values are given as y of x0 equal to y0, then value of y when x equal to xn can be calculated by the formula of fourth order RK method as y1 equal to y0 plus 1 by 6 into k1 plus 2k2 plus 2k3 plus k4, where k1, k2, k3, k4 are wages. Formulas for k1, k2, k3, k4 are as follows. Here, h can be calculated as xn minus x0 divided by n, where k1 equal to h into f of x0 y0 means you have to substitute initial approximations x0 and y0 in a given differential equation or given function so that you can easily find out value of k1. K2 equal to h into f of x0 plus h by 2 y0 plus k1 by 2. K3 equal to h into f of x0 plus h by 2, y0 plus k2 by 2, and k4 equal to h into f of x0 plus h and y0 plus k3. Let us solve problem for fourth order RK method. Using Runge Kutta fourth order method, solve following equation. Given that y of 0 equal to 1, h equal to 0.2, 0.2 and 0.4. Given function is dy by dx equal to x plus y square. So let us start a solution. Let dy by dx equal to x plus y square, which is given function in terms of x and y. So as it is given, y of 0 equal to 1 means when x equal to 0, value of y will be 1. As it is initial condition, so that's why we can write like this: x0 equal to 0, y0 equal to 1. Now here h is 0.2, which is given here. The meaning of this statement is that value is incremented from 0.2 to 0.4 with 0.2 as a value. So h equal to 0.2 given. Xn equal to 0.4. Now this is what is your last value that we have to find out, which is 0.4. H equal to xn minus x0 divided by n as per the formula. So here we can find out n equal to 2, as h is given, substitute value, xn means 0.4 and x0 is nothing but 0. So we'll get n equal to 2. So important note is that as the step size is given h equal to 0.2 and we have to calculate the value of y at xn equal to 0.4 with x0 equal to 0, the Runge Kutta formula is applicable for two iterations, means here value of n is nothing but equal to 2. Let us solve iteration number 1. So for iteration number 1, initial conditions are given when x0 equal to 0, y0 equal to 1. So we have to find out what is the value of y1 when x1 equal to 0.2. Formula is y1 equal to y0 plus 1 by 6 into bracket k1 plus 2 k2 plus 2 k3 plus k4. So we'll find out first all the wedges. K1 equal to h into f of x0 y0. Substitute all the values. K1 equal to h is 0.2, x0 is 0, y0 is 1. So formula for k1 is k1 equal to 0.2 into f of 0 comma 1. But as given function is f of xy equal to x plus y square. Now this value is x0, this value is y0. So we can write given function as x0 plus y0 square. So substitute x0 equal to 0, y0 equal to 1. We'll get answer for k1 as 0.2. Next is k2 equal to h into f of x0 plus h by 2 comma y0 plus k1 by 2. Substitute all the values. Here h is nothing but 0.2, x0 is 0, h is 0.2 divided by 2 comma y0 is 1 plus k1 is 0.2 divided by 2. So we will get answer as k2 into k2 equal to 0.2 into function, that is f of 0.1 comma 1.1. Now what we have to do? We have to substitute value of x as a 0.1 and value of y as a 1.1 in the given function. As given function is f of xy equal to x plus y square, so we can modify this k2 as 0.2 into x is 0.1, that's why here we have written 0.1, plus y square, y is 1.1, that's why here we have written 1.1 square. So answer for k2 is 0.262. Next is calculation of k3, which is given by h into f of x0 plus h by 2 comma y0 plus k2 by 2. Substitute all the values. So you will get k3 equal to 0.2 into f of 0.1 comma 1.131. Again, as the given function is in the form of x plus y square, so by substituting values we will get answer for k3 as 0.275. Similarly, we have to find out value of k4. So write down a formula, substitute the values, h is 0.2, x0 is 0, h is 0.2, y0 is 1 and k3 comes out to be 0.275. So substituting, we'll get k4 equal to 0.2 into f of 0.2 comma 1.275. So substitute the value of x as a 0.2 and y as 1.275 in the given function, we'll get answer for k4 as 0.365. So formula for y1 is y0 plus 1 by 6 into bracket k1 plus 2k2 plus 2k3 plus k4. Substitute all the values, we'll get answer for y1 is 1.2735. Hence we can write when x equal to 0.2, y equal to 1.2735. This is what is iteration number 1. Now next is iteration number 2. As in the question, it is mentioned that h equal to 0.2 bracket 0.2 bracket complete 0.4. So initially we have determined value of y when x equal to 0.2. Now we have to determine or calculate value of y when x equal to 0.4. Now in case of iteration number 2, what you have to do, the value of x and y which comes out in the previous iteration, it should be used as the initial condition for next iteration. So here x0 equal to 0.2, y0 equal to 1.2735. So what is the value of y1 when x1 equal to 0.2? Again we have to use same formula. So we have to calculate value of k1, substitute all the values. As function is x plus y square, so your answer for k1 is 0.364. Similarly, calculate value for k2, substitute all the values, and you will get answer for k2 as 0.4838. Similarly, calculate value of k3. So we will get answer for k3 as 0.5193 by substituting all the values. And calculate value of k4, substitute all the values. We will get answer for k4 as 0.7228. Then write down formula for y1. Substitute values of k1, k2, k3, k4 and y0. So by substituting all the values, we will get answer as 1.7891. So by substituting all the values, we will get answer for y when x equal to 0.4. So we can write answer in a table form. For iteration number 1, when x was 0.2, value of y comes out to be 1.2735. The same value of x and y you have to use as the initial condition for iteration number 2, and then you have to calculate when x equal to 0.4, y equal to 1.7891. Algorithm. Step number 1, start. Step number 2, write a given function, that is f of xy. Step number 3, read the initial values which are given, that is x0 and y0. Step number 4, read the value of x or xn at which y is to be determined. Step number 5, read the step size h. Step number 6, set x equal to x0 and y equal to y0. Use for loop, that is for I equal to 1, I less than or equal to n and I plus plus. Determine the value of wages, that is k1, k2, k3 and k4. Determine the value of y, that is y equal to y0 plus 1 by 6 into bracket k1 plus 2k2 plus 2k3 plus k4, and increment the value of x, that is x equal to x plus h. Display the result as the value of y is, and end. Let us start with program for fourth order arcane method. First step is hash include stdio.h, hash include conio.h and hash include math.h. Here stdio.h is the header file, that is standard input output, which includes printf and scanf. Conio.h is console input output, which includes the instruction clrscr, getch and return. We have to write down a given function, that is define a function f of x y equal to x plus y square. So that's why here we have written float f, float x comma float y, return. Here in the return we have written given function, that is x plus y square. Void main. Void main is necessary for every program. From this line onwards the program body starts. Int I comma n, that is initialization or declaration of variables which are used in the program. Here n is number of iterations and I is used for counting the iterations. Float x0 comma y0 comma h comma xn comma x comma y k1 k2 k3 and k4. Now again, this is also declaration of variable. Now here x0 and y0 are initial values given in the problem. As in the problem, it is given that y of 0 equal to 1 means x0 equal to 0 and y0 equal to 1. H is the step size or the spacing. Here in the problem, it has given that h equal to 0. Xn is the value of x at which the value of y is to be calculated. So here xn will be equal to 0.4. K1, K2, K3, K4 are the wages or the constants used in the formula of y. X and y are the variables that can be used in the formula of K1, K2, K3 and K4. CLR is here. It clears the previous output of a program when the new program executes. Now first step is enter the initial value of x0. Here the slash n is used for new line. As we have taken value of x0 under float instruction, so format specifier for float is %f, comma ampersand x0. Ampersand is nothing but address of the variable. So this particular statement will give enter the initial value of x0. Now from our problem, x0 is 0. Similarly, enter the initial value of y0. From our problem, value of y0 is 1. Enter the value of xn. Here xn is the value of x at which value of y is to be calculated. Here instead of taking value of xn equal to 0.2, we have taken final value, that is xn equal to 0.4 from the problem. Printf slash n, enter step size h. Here step size h is nothing but spacing. So from the problem, value of h equal to 0.2. N equal to xn minus x0 divided by h. So calculate the number of steps or the number of iterations required. So from the given problem, here number of iterations will be 2. X equal to x0 and y equal to y0 means value of x0 will be stored in x, value of y0 will be stored in y. Now here we have used for loop. This loop is used for calculation of y1 corresponding to the x1. I is used as a counter for counting iterations. Now here the value of I is starting from 1 and not from 0. This is because the given value x0 is mentioned in the problem and no need to calculate x0 value or y0 value here. So that's why here we have used I equal to 1. So when I equal to 1, for a first iteration, we have to take initial values as x equal to 0 and y equal to 1. And we have to find out values of k1, k2, k3 and k4. So write down formula for k1, that is h into f of x, y. So it will calculate the value of k1. Here h is 0.2. X and y will be 0, 1, that is 0, 1. So by substituting it in the given function, we will get answer for k1 as a 0.2. Similarly, we have to write formula for k2, which will give you answer for k2, which comes out to be 0.262. Calculate value of k3, so you will get answer for k3. Again calculate value of k4, we will get answer for k4 as 0.365. Now y equal to y plus 1 upon 6 into k1 plus 2 k2 plus 2 k3 plus k4. This is a formula for y1. Now initial value of y is 1. Okay. So when our answer is stored in the y, for our next iteration we have to use this value of y. So here answer for y is 1.2735. X equal to x plus h. Now initial value of x is 0 and h is 0.2. So we will get answer for when x equal to 0.2, y equal to 1.2735. Now the value of I is incremented. Initially it was 1. Now it becomes I equal to 2. For second iteration, x0 equal to 0.2 and y0 equal to 1.2735 will be initial condition. That is, answer from iteration 1 will be considered as initial values for iteration 2. Again, repeat the same procedure till n equal to 2, that is number of iterations. Now we have to print the result. So slash n, when x equal to percent if, y equal to percent if, comma x, comma y. So it will give the value of y for given value of x for each iterations. Get ch. It holds the output on the screen till we give any character or we press any key, that is output on the screen. This will be the output. So here x0 equal to 0, y0 equal to 1. Xn is final value of x for which we have to calculate value of y. So from the problem it is 0.4, h is 0.2. So whenever x equal to 0.2, our answer will be 1.2735, and when x equal to 0.4, our answer is 1.7891. Thank you. This is what is a C programming explanation for Runge Kutta method. If you have any doubt, then you can ask me. Please like my video and subscribe my channel. Thank you.